Welcome back, everyone, to my playthrough of Super Mario RPG for the Switch. Please check the intro to the first part of the series if you're interested to hear what sorts of commentary you can expect from me. I'm coming in here at the beginning not to point out that this scene with Mallow is still in the game, although it is indeed, and it's quite humorous, but rather to note that there's an option in the menu that I discovered that I wanted to talk about for a bit because it was tripping me up in the first part of this run. Namely, you can change it to where the inputs in combat are consistent across menus, i.e. in the special menu you would continue pressing Y as opposed to Y and then A. So I'm glad that they kept the option to have that in there because that's how it was in the SNES and it kind of gave me a little trouble. There's an Easter egg or oversight from the original that I wanted to check and see if it was still possible in the remake, namely that you can get into combat with this Boo here, run away from it, and then use its invincibility frames to jump on top of the Boo and then reach these upper platforms that you're not supposed to be able to get to until later in the game. I'm not going to do it here because, as you can probably tell, I'm still struggling with the analog controls. I'm much more used to the D-pad on the SNES for this game, but it is nice to see that that early skip to Land's End is still possible. Well, it took clearing that truly obnoxious battle against the special shy guy, but I am genuinely surprised to see that I was able to get this frog coin here. In the SNES version, I could never get this, but I pulled it off here. This gives me a tiny bit of hope for a later section that demands precision platforming in this game that I'm already terrified of, given my difficulties with the analog control.
Thank you.
This is one of the tougher segments of hunting for treasure boxes, because a lot of the areas here look almost identical, But in the remake, some of them are even a little harder to find, and you'll notice that I put on the signal ring to help out with that. And that's because on the SNES, these underground sections have these very obvious circles of light in them that can kind of help you gauge where these treasure boxes are located relative to the light. But because there's more realistic lighting on the Switch, that's no longer there as a guide, so you really just kind of have to flail around and hope you find them, even if you know which rooms they're in. More hidden treasure problems. What threw me off here is that there's no longer a transition scene between this one long corridor with the save box and the boss room. I ended up getting thrown into the fight earlier than I would have wanted, but don't worry, I do get to go back and find this missing hidden treasure after the battle. Thank you.
think it's funny that Bowyer locks you out of Toad Assist, and also that this fight will eventually set up the concept of triple moves. This battle ended up being very messy for me. I very much regretted not buying any pick-me-ups, but I was glad to see that the scripted triple move finish kind of saved me at the end. And anyway, this isn't a perfect run, and I'm sure there's some entertainment value to be gained from watching me screw up to such a degree and just barely pull out a victory here.
Thank you.
If you're wondering what's going on here, it took me a little while to figure out that in order to duck under this gap, you have to press down on the analog stick. That was true on the SNES with the D-pad, but it just wasn't clicking for me for some reason, or I was trying to press down, but it wasn't quite going. Like I said before, I don't think analog control is a really great fit for this game. Thank you. Why not close this section out with something embarrassing? I have never been able to complete the Mushroom Derby on the SNES, and I thought that it might be a little easier this time. Maybe they changed the timing for the buttons, because you have to tap in time to the rhythm, and I did notice in previews that they do have the buttons on the screen now, where that was not true originally. But as you can see from my performance here, I still don't have the rhythm necessary to clear this. I am glad that there is nothing really significant locked behind this race, although there are some interesting items that I wish I could have access to, but it doesn't seem to be working for me. I mean, I might go back and try it again at some other point, but I think I am going to just close World 2 off here, because next time we're going to be moving ahead to the next section, Moleville. So I hope if you enjoyed this that you will leave a like and subscribe to my channel so that you can continue to keep up with this series as I go on. I'm doing an episode every couple of days. I'm going to be clearing the whole game like this. So make sure to subscribe so you don't miss part 3. Au revoir!